We love talking to people anyway. You know, we do the online game. We do click to buy. You can absolutely buy things on our website. We would love to talk to you.
You know, that's actually very commendable. Because if it was, use Amazon.com as an example.
Yep.
No one calls to talk to people at Amazon.
And you can't.
And it's very impersonal. Yep. But the fact that you give us a call, that's pretty meaningful.
You know, we know that times have changed. You want to be able to check out online. You want to be able to do things from home. You don't always have the ability to go to a store and try something. But we're here. We'll get the guitar in our hands. We'll tell you what it's about. We've touched enough that we kind of know what's going on with it. And we want to make sure that, you know, you're getting not what reads right, but what actually is right. And that's really what the deal is.
That's awesome.
This is a relationship business. This is not about, you know, just shipping boxes out the door.
So here I am at Chuck Levin's, also known as Washington Music Center.
That's it.
With Adam Levin.
How's it going?
So is it Washington Music Center or Chuck Levin's? Or
we
is
go
it
by Chuck's, Chuck Levin's, Chuck Levin's Washington Music Center.
Whatever you want
Whatever you want to do. We're here.
All right. So we're going to do the tour. I'm going to flip the camera around and we're going to check out this awesome place. So here we go.
So this is Chuck Levin's Washington Music Center. This year, 2018, is our 60th anniversary. We actually got our start in 1958 downtown in Washington, D.C. And if you look around back here, that's an image of the original store. It's down on H Street Northeast in D.C. Little one-room mom-and-pop shop. We got Chuck, my grandfather, on the left, and Marge, his wife, on the right. And it was born out of a pawn shop. My grandfather just loved the business. He always said that music was a happy business. So he just loved the people. He loved the wheeling and dealing and just kind of making deals and getting instruments in people's hands and seeing just the smiles on their face and things like that. So that was 1958, and over the next 10 years, he just made a name for himself in the city. Anyone coming through would stop in and see Chuck. And in 1968, when the riots happened in D.C. and Martin Luther King was assassinated, riots all through the city and the store was burned to the ground. And I've been doing a lot of investigating this year about it, and the story goes that if there had been a wall standing, they would have rebuilt there. And there was literally nothing. I'll show you another point. There's just warp drums that were just like shells that were left on the ground, and that was all that was left. So 3 months later, we moved into this building here, and we had this one floor. And so that was 50 years ago this year. And since then, we've pretty much taken over this entire block. So we have 5 buildings of warehouses. We have 2 buildings with showrooms. 100 people work here, and 26 sales staff in specific departments so they can really be experts of what they do. So I'll give you a little walk around the tour, kind of show you how the operations works. We are what I like to think of as one of the last of Mohicans. We are one of the last like old school music stores. Still doing volume like a lot of the big guys do, but we're really as old school as it gets, and I'll show you some of that. So right at the front up here, we have our accessories department. This is the department that has everything that makes everything else go. So reeds, mouthpieces, cables, you know, cases, pickups, guitar pedals. You want to try out a Wampler versus an Earthquake or versus a JHS pedal, and pull them out, let you just mess with all of them and just tear it up and have some fun. Over here we have our microphone department. So we do live microphones, studio microphones, wireless wired, in-ear systems, all kinds of stuff. We have a whole room next door where we can demo studio microphones and their preamps, and you can match anything, top 48 mics and top 48 preamps, and you can AV anything. Back over here we have our drum department, and for being in the same building we've been in for 50 years, we don't really have space to set up drum kits. But the guys, we sell a lot of acoustic drum kits. The guys know what they're doing. They know the type of music, what we have in stock, what's going to work for you. We special order from Gretsch and RVH and CNC, Ludwig, DW. So we're in every which way of doing it. A lot of snare drums, a lot of electronic drum kits, a lot of world percussion. We have djembes, we have cajon, we have a whole cymbal room.
Hello.
Back over here, we just got some of the fun, but I'll show you kind of where the real secrets are kept in the basement in a minute.
Awesome.
That's where things get real fun. If you walk back over this way, we'll get into what you guys probably are more familiar with, which is our guitar department. So here we have the guitar department, everything from your Gibson wall, your Paul Reed Smith wall, your Fender Custom Shop, Gretsch's.
And what you're seeing is the tip of the iceberg
Yeah, we're going to go underneath the iceberg.
That's what Carlos was telling us.
What the guy in the crow's nest of the Titanic is seeing is one thing. What actually took that ship down is a whole other thing. You're going to see that.
So Paul Shine's been here for what now?
A minute. 37 years.
37 yeah. years. So he's been in, you know, a lot of these guitar manufacturers will ask for Paul's advice on things because he's seen more guitars come through and what works and what doesn't than most guys in most stores have existed for.
Awesome.
I've screwed up more than most people have come.
There you go.
Fun little fact, Paul Reed Smith Guitars, we have a really tight relationship with Paul Reed Smith. Paul used to work here when he was a kid. So when he was 18 and he
really?
Was just kind of figuring
yeah,
himself out.
He guitars here.
Learned to
really?
Fix his guitars here and on the side he would be working on his custom 24, his original one, and we were one of the first people to actually...
We are his oldest dealer.
Yeah. We gave him the first PO for the custom 24
right.
and that's
right
kind of how
that
this
spot,
thing got going.
Right there, it should have a little plaque
and it was,
right there.
It was Paul that said, all right, this is a thing.
Well,
we'll
the
do
guitar was so spectacular that a monkey could have made the call. I just happened to be the monkey that made the call.
Nice.
The guitar was that obviously good when you first encountered it.
Do you have any originals?
None of the originals, not
well,
from back then.
Your dad's.
I have, yeah. We have some couple. We have some dragons. We have some cool stuff.
Really?
I have one I'll show you. If you want to wait a second. So when Chuck passed away, you know, Paul's basically like family. So when Chuck passed away back in 2002, Paul made a special guitar that kind of commemorates the family. And I'll go pull that in a second.
Yeah.
Which I designed.
And
did you really?
So for our...
Yeah, I was inspired by the famous Jackson Marilyn Monroe with the timeline fretboard inlays.
Yeah, I'll get it when
okay. you're showed, sure. Showed the events of her life in fretboard inlays. Mm-hmm. So I basically designed a fretboard inlay that showed, you know, Chuck born in New York.
Really?
You know, and all the key events, you
wow.
know, married Marge, opened the store, the birth of the children. It was very tasteful.
Oh, that's awesome.
It was cool.
Very cool.
The best we could come up with. Oh, it's here?
It's here.
Uh-oh.
I'm ready for you.
Uh-oh. So I'm going to get all choked up. I haven't seen this since it happened.
Just have the guys in the shop clean it up.
Wow. There it is.
Wow.
There it is.
It is an epic hollow body. And you can see. So that's when Chuck was born. That's when Chuck and Marge got married. Their eldest son, Alan, who's still the president of the company. Middle child, Abby, who's still here and involved in one of the owners of the company. The youngest son, who's my dad, Robert, when he was born. When the store was opened. When the fires happened, when the riots happened. When it reopened in Wheaton, Maryland,
mm-hmm.
just a couple months later. And then when he passed away.
Wow.
Of 02. And just an, I mean, epic guitar. So cool. So for this year, for our 60th anniversary, we're actually working on a couple really cool limited edition things.
So what was the name of that model? What is there a name to it? Is it named?
Let's see what it says on the back.
It just says
custom built for the Levin family, 92303, Pardsmith. But for this year, for our 60th anniversary this year, we're actually working with a lot of our oldest partners to make limited edition 60th anniversary models. So
that's
we're working on, and these are all going to be, you know, unique, commemorative, awesome guitars in their own right, but special for our 60th anniversary. So we're going to do some with Paul Reed Smith. We're going to do some Fenders, some Strats, and some Tellies. We're going to do some Martin guitars. We're also working on getting some Taylors, some limited edition cymbals. Some limited edition snare drums, so just some really cool stuff to just kind of commemorate the people that have helped us be a part of the music industry for 60 years. After the riots, we have a whole book full of letters from a lot of these manufacturers that said, hey, we heard there was a catastrophe and that you guys are on hard times. Let us know what you need, float the bills as long as you need to.
Wow.
And we wouldn't exist without that sort of support. And because of that, Chuck made it a point that within the first year of being back, he paid everyone back in full. So he was not about to take their generosity for nothing. So he made sure that every single one of the vendors that we owed money to was paid in full before the end of the first year. And that kind of skyrocketed this place to becoming what it is today.
Wow.
It was with that success and that drive that we're able to take over the rest of the city block out in Wheaton.
That's great.
So. We'll keep going so we can get into the basement. In here we have the acoustic room.
We do a quick pan of this good stuff. All right, let's check it out.
Come on in.
Thank you.
So here we have the acoustic room. We recently remodeled it. Humidity control so guitars don't explode.
I saw that the other day.
Yeah.
Let's see.
It's happened.
It happens.
Here it is.
Always humidify your guitars. So in here we have...
You think even for electric guitars?
It's best practice to. It's not as imperative that you do, but acoustics certainly really can get messed up if you're not treating them right. Electrics are a little more durable in that regard.
Because it's finished wood, right?
It's finished wood, not hollow, so it's a little more stable the whole way through. Here the hard part is that the tension can pull the bridge off the body, and because it's so frail, it's such a thin top.
Right.
There's not a lot underneath it to grab onto. But in here we have your Martins, your Gibsons, your Fenders, your Taylor Smiths, Eastman, Seagull, you do custom ones, classical guitars, mandolins, ukuleles, traveler guitars, banjos, banjolales, banjitars, every which way you need to play a stringed instrument.
This is great.
Back in here we have, the amps, we have Bassland down there, we do, custom Brubakers, Ken Smith basses, we have some Sire basses, Marcus Miller Sire basses, Music Mans.
Yeah, most of the brands that came into the world in the 80s, not the original Fender, Gibson, Gretsch, Rickenbacker, but pretty much everything you know from the 80s, Kramer, Hamer, Steinberger, Spector, Ken Smith, Paul Smith, Taylor, Boogie, we did all that. In other words, we did all that.
Still try to.
Cool.
So let's get under the iceberg here. Let's kind of get into it. Let's show you what's going on down in the basement. Back in here, we have our studio recording department and keyboard department. So synths, studio interfaces, beat machines, studio monitors, analog, digital, all which ways of recording music and making music with other things we do back here. Moog, Dave Smith, Korg, Yamaha, Roland, all that sort of stuff.
Hi, how are you?
Doing great.
Awesome.
That sent me an invite.
Now we're getting into it.
Up to you.
So, the basement is the closest by warehouse. We have four warehouses. This building having one of them. And then we have a building that's just a warehouse that's in the back of our parking lot. And then we have a building that's a warehouse that's across Georgia Avenue, which is one of the freeways around here. And then we have a warehouse down the street that has more overstock stuff. So if we go down this way, microphone stands, gig bags, so here we are at Guitar Land.
Wow.
So from this wall over here, down these aisles and all the way over to that aisle down there.
All guitars.
All the way up to the ceiling and all the way down is nothing but guitars and cases.
Wow.
So
hello.
You want to see something, it might not be on our floor, chances are it's down here.
Do you have all this on your website or where could people
Not
learn about?
Everything that we have in stock is on our website. Mm-hmm. I'll show you in a minute, we take our own product photography. So the guitars you see online in general are the ones we actually have in stock. And to do that just takes a little bit of time. So to get them up and accurate and just to deal with the flow of in and out. Not everything's up to date, but we love talking to people anyway. We do the online game, we do click to buy. You can absolutely buy things on our website. We would love to talk to you.
You know, that's actually very commendable. Because if it was, use Amazon.com as an example.
Yep.
No one calls to talk to people at Amazon.
And you can't.
And it's very impersonal. Yep. But the fact that give us a call, that's pretty meaningful.
We know that times have changed. You want to be able to check out online. You want to be able to do things from home. You don't always have the ability to go to a store and try something. But we're here. We'll get the guitar in our hands. We'll tell you what it's about. We've touched enough that we kind of know what's going on with it. And we want to make sure that, you know, you're getting not what reads right, but what actually is right. And that's really what the deal is.
That's awesome.
This is a relationship business. This is not about, you know, just shipping boxes out the door.
Nice.
So we have Gibsons, Epiphones, Taylors. So we have four full-time guitar techs on staff. Mm-hmm. We have one guy that helps get everything set up. So if you are going to order a guitar online, it's set up by Ryan right there.
Hello.
He's going to make sure it's all set up to the specs that you want. So if you say you want 11s or you want 10s on your electric, Ryan's one that's going to make sure that it's right going out the door. Then we also do we have a full service shop that does all the pickups or wiring or, you know, refretting or whatever you might need to do. We also warranty service centers for a lot of the major dudes. So Fender, Taylor, whatever that might be. So we're here to support music. You know, it's not just transactional. It is about so much more than that. But yeah, this is the bottom of the iceberg.
What would you say the most common guitar repair you do is?
I don't know. What'd you say, Ryan?
Probably general setups and stuff like
okay.
that.
Okay.
That's daily. I mean, you know, a couple guitars happening every single day at all different levels, too. It's going to be a Squire 1 second. It's going to be a custom shop the next second. Mm-hmm. It's going to be a Taylor Acoustic the next. But no day is the same. You know, that's the beauty of the music industry is that someone's always doing something different, even if it's the same instrument. Mm-hmm. They're still finding a way to use it differently, or they want to do something weird with it, and that's the art of it. That's
awesome.
What we do.
Cool. Very cool.
I'll give you a little another lap around the basement so you can kind of
see. Nice meeting you. Yeah. Thank you.
So down here we have our photo studio.
Yep. Hello.
So the first half of the day is all receiving trucks. So right now they're all receiving things and bringing the boxes down so that we can put it into inventory.
Nice.
This is our photo studio. So we take the pictures of the guitars, the drum kits, the snare drums, even things like synthesizers and microphones, because a stock photo only does so well.
Right.
When you can really see the grain of the wood, and something like a Paul Reed Smith guitar, there is no stock photo. So if you just use a stock photo to represent...
Especially when you're ordering custom pieces, which you do a lot of.
A lot of them, and even just the core model PRS guitar.
Right.
One grain of wood is not the same as the next, even though it's the same model.
Right.
A custom 24 in Santana yellow is not always the same. So you got to see it.
Wow, what a great...
It's what it's about, you know. In the day of digital, you know, transactions, and you still want to do things online, you want to see what you're about to do.
Sure.
You still want to kind of get your hands on as best you can.
Yep.
That's what we try and do down here.
Nice studio.
I'll show you a little more of this basement.
So Ryan, 385, Ryan, 385.
So back in here we have Drumland.
Hello?
So this is where we keep drum hardware, snare drums, cymbals, drum heads, sticks, tambourines, shakers, everything but the actual drum kits. Those are actually kept in the back warehouse. But we come back in here.
I'm enjoying the artwork.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's all the little
Things.
All the little things. The bumper stickers, the handwritten notes on the wall.
More drums and more places. All the sticks in the world. You wanna try some sticks? You wanna see what's out there? It's here. And all the guys on the floor really use this stuff. I mean they're really doing it. A lot of our salespeople, a lot of our employees have been here 10 plus years, going up to someone like Paul's been here 37, so
wow.
We try and keep on to them. You know, everyone that comes in is like family. It's me, my aunt, my uncle, and then 100 other people that are all family to us.
So family-wise, actual Levin family, there's you?
There's me, my uncle, my aunt. My dad was my mentor, my man.
Sure.
He passed away in 2013.
Sorry to hear that, by the way.
So, thank you. So, you know, I worked with him for 3 years. As much as I possibly could, but once he passed, I had 100 people here to help me do it.
That's great.
You know,
that's great.
Really, if that isn't a microcosm of what this place really is, that it's a team effort and a family thing for God.
Really nice meeting you, and what a wonderful store.
Thank you.
Thank you for the tour.
Thank you.
An amazing store. If people want to reach out, have any questions, how do they reach out?
Absolutely. We're www.chucklevins.com. We're in Wheaton, Maryland, just outside of D.C. You can find us on Facebook, Chuck Levins. Our Twitter and Instagram handles are both just at Chuck Levins. And check us out online. Give us a call. Shoot us an email. We'd love to hear from you.
Love to hear from you. Pick up the phone. Give a call. I love it.
That's why we're here.
There it is.